Hiya crafters, Amy here, and today we're playing with some marvelous mask stencils. Now if you don't know what these are from A Colorful Life Designs, and Mary Kay at the shop has a whole line of these innovative stencils. As you can see, they come with the outside and the inside portion of the stencil, and this particular one is the Marvelous Masks Balloon Stencil. I'm going to also be using a few other older stencils from the shop. We have Dot Duo, Chevron Dot, and Scattered Bling. So you're going to see me use these together, layering them up, but there's so many different ways you can use these stencils. So I do have other videos where I've played with different Marvelous Mask stencils from the shop, so I will link those in the video description box below if you want to check those out after this. But I'm going to jump right in here. I'm just going to kind of line these up kind of all over my card panel here. I have an A2 size card panel of 110 pounds cardstock, and I have my mini ink pads from Catherine Pooler. And I'm just going to work through different colors, nice bright rainbow colors, make a nice festive celebratory card. But I'm just kind of going darker on, you know, the edges of the balloon and maybe a little bit lighter in the center, kind of how they would be in real life if you look at them. So you'll see that's what I'm doing here. I have the biggest of the balloons right off the edge of the card, and I'm just kind of leaving it lighter in the center on purpose. And then I'm going to come in with another stencil to add some design onto it. So stick around to the end. I'm actually going to show you a bonus card in a different way that you can use these stencils. But for this card, I'm layering them up and adding some additional color and texture to give it some interesting design. So I have this Scattered Bling stencil, and I'm coming in with that orange color from Catherine Pooler just to add that fun design to the balloon. Now I'm going to go down to the next smaller size. And I will work through all four sizes and then add another one a second time because I like to work in odd numbers. So I have this aquatini color that I'm going to come through next. And same thing, kind of going darker on the edge, a little bit lighter in the center, just to kind of give it that illusion of a highlight or give it that 3D round look. Which obviously balloons are round, so that's what I'm doing here, and just laying down the ink. And then I'm going to pick a different stencil here. I have the Duo Dots, and I was originally going to use that Something Borrowed color, but then I thought, I'll just come in with the aquatini and come down darker with the ink. So I'm using a little bit of a heavier hand and just laying the same color of ink down on top of that balloon, so it's a monochromatic look, but I didn't want it to be too drastic. And I also didn't want to make it too busy, so I didn't actually put designs on all of the balloons that I went through. I wanted to leave some of them like a solid color. So I'm just kind of figuring out where I want it to overlap. You don't have to put too much thought into it, but where your colors do overlap, you are going to create another color. So that is something that you want to consider. If you're, you know, if I were to be laying this reddish color over a more traditional green rather than this kind of bluish teal green, then it might make a little bit of a muddier color. So apply some color theory when you're, you know, layering these inks on top of each other if you don't want to get kind of a dull look. You know, really it's pretty hard to mess up, but it's just something to keep in mind as you go along. And now I'm using that Something Borrowed color, and again, just doing another little balloon in the front. And on this one, I decided to use the Chevron Dot stencil on top of it. And again, I'm just going to use that same ink, just press a little bit harder, a little bit of a heavier hand, just to lay down that design. And you can see how quickly this is coming together. Obviously, I have the footage sped up. I'm not moving quite this quickly, but honestly, these mask stencils are just so easy to use and fun. So I'm going to add that fifth balloon here, and I'm looking at the colors that I've already used, and I've basically got, you know, a whole rainbow for the most part. So I'm just kind of figuring out like, oh, well, if I overlap and it goes over that orange, with the green, that might not look so good. So I'm kind of just, you know, organizing it so that it goes more over that teal color rather than the orange little stars on the yellow balloon. So you got a nice highlight in the center of the balloon there. And yeah, isn't that fun? I just, I love it. I'm excited to play with these some more. So I have some Gina Marie Designs rectangle dies. I'm just using that to cut out this fun whimsical edge, and I'm just flipping through my sentiment book to figure out what sentiment I want to put on it. I know I want to make it a birthday card, but I'm not sure which sentiment, so I'm just kind of looking through what I have here, see if I want to use anything, and I decide to go with that cute partay that I have cut out of some glitter cardstock. And I'm just going to adhere that panel down to the A2 size card base. And I'm not putting any dimension on it. I'm keeping it nice and flat. I feel like it's busy enough. I'm just gonna, you know, go with it. But I have a light grayish silver gel pen, and I just quickly draw on some little strings, like in a bow on the bottom of the balloons, and little strings that kind of hang down a little bit. And I thought that was a nice little match to the silver glittery color on the sentiment that I cut out. So I'm just using some liquid glue with my fine tip here, and I know it's going to squish out the sides, so I just tap off that excess on some scratch paper and then use my tweezers and put that down right on that red balloon in the center. So I decide I want to add a little bit of bling. I get some silver sequins, and again, odd number. Just lay those down with my jewel picker here and the same liquid glue. And that's going to finish this card. And stick around just a moment. I'm going to show you the other card that I made with these same Marvelous Mask balloon stencils. Oh, quick, I'm going to add some little highlights with a gel pen. You definitely want to do that with balloons because that's what you'd expect, right? You always got to have that nice bright white highlight mark on the balloons. So I'm just hand drawing that on, struggling a little bit to get the ink out. I know you guys have probably experienced that as well when they clog up on you. I'm just kind of adding that little fine extra little detail onto the card. And it's, other than the dimension from the sequins, it's nice and flat. It should ship pretty easily. Just show you the close up here. And then here's the other card that I made last night. I did lighter, more muted colors. I didn't do the pattern, but I thought, isn't that a cute baby card? So you could make this for any celebration, birthdays, for new babies. I did use a corner chomper here and rounded off a couple of the edges to give it some additional interest. But again, other than that sentiment strip being popped up, there's really not a whole lot of dimension, so it should be easy to ship. And yeah, these are such fun ways to use these stencils. I'm so excited to have another Marvelous Mask set in my stash. Wow, it's a tongue twister. Anyway, thanks for sticking with me. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the thumbs up. And I appreciate you. Leave me comments. Let me know what you think. I'll catch you next time. Thank you. Bye.